Hi, I'm Mr. B, one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. If you're a microeconomics student, you might be wondering about the trade-off between equity and efficiency. Lucky for you, we're here to help. It's based on the assumption that it costs money, time, and resources to produce goods and services. Here, we see a market for genes. If not enough genes are produced, the price will increase and few people will buy them. If too many genes are produced, then they will be too cheap and the company will struggle to stay afloat. Instead, the gene company will want to make the optimal amount of genes so that all of the genes they produce are sold for as much money as possible without any pairs going unbought. This is represented by E star, where the two lines cross. E star thus stands for market efficiency, the quantity and price where all resources are optimally used. Equity, on the other hand, is an idea that wasn't developed by economists. Equity refers mostly to fairness. For instance, let's say you are in the cafeteria and have no food. Your friend next to you has a full lunch. Then your friend is randomly selected by the school to receive another lunch for free. In this situation, there is no equity. You'll sit with an empty stomach while they have too much. While equity is relevant in most disciplines, we can apply it uniquely in economics. In economics, equity refers to wealth distribution. In a fully equitable society, everyone would have an equal amount of wealth. But as you may know, this often isn't the case. Economists often use the principle of utilitarianism in their work. This is the idea that we should strive to do the greatest good for the greatest amount of people. In economics, we define efficiency as the economic state where every resource is allocated optimally while minimizing waste. In other words, we should be efficient. Sometimes, however, it means that certain people do not benefit. Let's use cold medicine as an example. Here we see a normal market. At the optimal rate, just enough cold medicine will be produced so that everyone who is able to pay the optimal price buys it. Producing more cold medicine will lower the price, and producing less cold medicine will raise it. E star will get the company the most amount of money selling the highest amount of medicine. Even though we know that E star is the efficient production and demand rate, it isn't necessarily fair. After all, just because someone can't afford cold medicine, does that mean they shouldn't be able to get it? Economists have to consider if having an efficient market is worth the trade-off in equity. Politicians and economists everywhere have to work together to determine how much inefficiency is acceptable in the name of equity. While many markets, like the market for genes, don't involve government intervention, sometimes intervention is necessary to prevent too much inequity. For instance, the government places higher taxes on the extremely rich rather than the extremely poor. For another example, many pharmacies also offer free antibiotics for those who can't afford them. There is significant debate over how much efficiency is okay to lose in the name of equity. As economists, it's our job to help determine what the most efficient market will look like, but we also have to accept that true efficiency sometimes just isn't an option. Thanks for watching this Chegg video. Come back to view more videos, see example problems, or ask for help from one of our Chegg subject matter experts.